aš pasirinkau visgi kalbėti anglų kalbą, kadangi turime daug svečių iš užsienio. Jau supratot, lietuvių irgi šiek tiek moku kalbą, bet toliau kalbėsiu angliškai. Dear ministers, dear guests, dear all colleagues and all the participants. My name is Agnė Rimantė and I'm a senior researcher at the Law Institute of Lithuania. I speak here today in the name of the Law Institute because regretfully our director, Jurgita Paužiūtė-Klovinskienė, was not able to be here today with us due to important personal reasons. She asked me to welcome you in her name, to send her warm greetings, and she wishes us a constructive event. Let me join the already expressed gratitude to everyone who came to this conference. To see so many people here is very important to us, because in this way you show that the topic which we are covering is indeed interesting for a very wide audience. It is very important to all of us, all the people who work for this conference can happen. Also in the name of the Law Institute, I should say a special thank you to the Lithuanian State Legal Aid Service, who did all the job of organizing this event. It's indeed a very hard work to do and everything seems to be just perfect. I'm here shortly to present you the project under which the conference is taking place, as well as our international team and the results we seek to achieve. As many of you have already understood, the conference organized implementing the international EU co-funded project, which is entitled Enhancing the Quality of Legal Aid, General Standards for Different Countries, or QLAID, a short name for it. This is why I have a small EU flag on our presentation. It's a EU-funded project, so one of the requirements is to show that to you as well. In this international project led by the Law Institute of Lithuania, the experts from three countries, from Germany, the Netherlands and Lithuania, pooled together their knowledge and experience for one common target. You see here on the slide. For this project we seek to contribute to enhancing the quality of legal aid services in criminal proceedings in the European Union. Our input would be developing the common standards for legal aid provision and quality, supervision and raising capacity of legal aid policymakers, administrators and legal aid providers from the perspective of quality of legal aid. In a few minutes I will come back a bit explaining more about the project and the things that we do under this project, but first of all let me introduce to you our international team. There are five bodies or five institutions which formed a consortium due to common wish to work together towards improvement of the quality of legal aid across the European Union. Our different backgrounds ensure that not only different countries with their different perspectives are present, not only that we can collect the most experienced people in that area, but also we have collected the partners which also present a different aspect, a different dimension of the legal aid. That's why we have two academic scientific institutions, Lithuanian Law Institute and Goethe University of Frankfurt, which are representing the scientific point of view in our research and in our work. Then we have two national legal aid boards, the Lithuanian and the Dutch, who represent the institutions entrusted with administering legal aid. Moreover, and I would say an incredible asset to our team is to have the Lithuanian Bar. Lithuanian Bar Association represents the position of the lawyers. It gives us a bit down-to-earth approach and understanding from a totally different side. Sometimes when discussing from a policy perspective, we forget also that there is this person, a lawyer, who needs to go and work with the client. Naturally, however, we do not have the legal aid residents represented, but we do our best to have their voice heard through the interviews, through the surveys we have in our research. A few words about each of the partners. Jochen Bolden, Goethe University of Frankfurt, as you understand, is an academic institution. Its outstanding staff is indeed the experts in legal aid and criminal proceedings in general, both at national level and the European Union level. Project researchers, if you see their CVs, they are performing numerous research and providing legal aid expertise on legal aid topics in various countries. They introduced us to the German model, learned a lot about their system, and they offer us a very strong scientific input to our common work. The German researchers in our team include Professor Christoph Buchen, as well as Matthias Jan, who you see right next to me, and Sarah Zee. Our Dutch partner is the National Legal Aid Board of the Netherlands. It is an institution actually entrusted with the administration, supervision, expenditure, as well as actual implementation of the legal aid system in the Netherlands. Helman Schutterloh, the head of the board staff, researchers Leah Combrick, Dr. Suzanne Peters, have a really long-term experience. When you talk to them, you understand that they are in the system at least 10 years and even much more. They cover the Netherlands dimension, and also they offer our team both the expertise in analytical activities and in knowing the area in general. The Lithuanian side is represented by two organizations. It is the Lithuanian State Guaranteed Legal Aid Service and the Lithuanian Bar Association, whom I already mentioned. The State Guaranteed Legal Aid Service, similar to Dutch institution, is entrusted with the matters of administration and implementation of legal aid system in our country. It also directly contributes to implementing European Union legal acts into our national system, so they also have a lot of experience from that perspective. Their knowledge, their expertise, experience, and in general, the very positive attitude towards our project is very useful for us, very inevitable, I would say, for the success of our project. Just before the lunch, we'll have an opportunity to meet and to listen to the head of the institution, Dr. Angelika Banerjana, who is not only the distinguished expert in the area, but also is giving a lot of efforts for this project to be successful. Lithuanian Bar Association, it's Lithuanian organization of all the lawyers, advocates, and advocate assistants in the country. They cover, I would say, 3,000 people. Basically, everyone who is in the bar is in this association. They give us another dimension, as already mentioned, presenting the lawyers' view. Dr. Ignas Vegeli, who was not able to come today, as well as Laurinas Biekša, you will see him in the second session today, and their colleagues are really contributing for this project to have also the practical aspect from the lawyer side. So BAR's participation is of extreme help for this event, for this project in total, and we expect it will be very helpful in the part of the project where we're going to have the international trainings. Just a few words about the Law Institute of Lithuania, because we often get questions, especially from the foreigners, what type of body is it? In general, we are a research establishment which was founded already in 1991 after the establishment of Lithuanian independence. And at that time, we were meant to assist in carrying on the legal reforms which were implemented in all the country in various years. Since 2012, we have already the status of National Research Institute. We do many things. We do researches, studies. We give our expert opinions on draft laws, expert opinions if we have requests from the national courts or other institutions. As well, we work, of course, on the international project. That's already a natural thing to do nowadays. And in the Global Aid project, the project under which this conference is happening, we are a leading partner. So I think so much about the partners, and it's time for me to go to present for you a bit the structure of our project in general. This project, the Global Aid project, as I would say in short, not to repeat all this long name, is in essence based on three blocks, or three working streams, as we call it. The first activity of our project would be the assessment of existing legal aid frameworks and practices aimed at ensuring high-quality legal aid in criminal proceedings. The experts from Lithuania, from Germany, from Holland have already prepared the analysis of their national respective legal aid systems and shared it between departments. We also finalizing our interviews and surveys in each of three countries with the questions we have for the stakeholders, for legal aid residents. In the upcoming months, hopefully before the spring, we will have two-day workshops in each country where the partners will discuss the conclusions of our researches with other people. Under this activity is also this international conference, as you see here. And we will finish this block by, of course, preparing the report. The second block of our work, this first block is kind of preparatory work for our main task in this project. The second block, the second activity, would be preparation of practice standards for legal aid providers in terms of reference for quality audit of legal services. Based on our findings, all the information we collect in the first section, first block, we will draft two documents, the practice standards for legal aid providers and terms of reference for the quality audit, which we will later discuss and which we will later distribute in between 28 member state countries for wider expert evaluation. There will be also international workshop organized under this working stream to validate and to finalize the development of the standards. Once we have those documents drafted, of course, it will not be a compulsory European Union or national legal act. We will present it as a mandatory act to the legal aid administrators, policymakers, or providers for further implementing and for their further use. All in all, we hope that our work will be useful and will contribute to making the legal aid quality a bit higher. The second block of our project will be meant for the training of people. It's called capacity building of legal aid policymakers, administrators, and legal aid providers. And here we will organize, first of all, we will develop three separate trainings for different target groups, and then we will carry on the trainings in each of the partner countries. By all this structure, as I already said, we will not change the system totally, but we really believe that at least a step forward, a little bit better, we can also do. I believe this gives you a background understanding about the project and which this conference is taking place. I also hope that this will encourage you to follow our activities, maybe to join our future workshops or trainings, which will be next year. At the moment, I put you the website of our project, where you will find a lot of materials, including you can find all the information about the speakers whom you will hear, the program of the conference later on. There will be additional inputs on it where more material information will be presented.